Well, let's be clear. After today, it's hard to hold that view. So we have changed our call, obviously, given what he has said today. So we are now looking for a 25 basis point cut. But what you said still holds true. We don't necessarily think that the economy needs a cut at this point. But, you know, we're not going to make some moral stand. The chairman wants to cut. He was quite clear on that. What I thought was interesting about how the press conference started with him was he basically said nothing changed since the June meeting. And I would say a number of things did change. You know, we have at least a tiny bit of clarity on trade post G20, right? We moved, sort of a step in the right direction. We now know that the payroll report from the previous month was sort of a one-off, thanks to the most recent payroll report. So, the fact that he didn't give any weight to any of these factors, I think really drives home that, you know, they are obviously very worried about where we are from a trade perspective globally. And, but I think this all begs the question, what is a 25 basis point cut or a 50 basis point cut going to do from a mitigation perspective as it relates to trade? And we would say the impact there is going to be incredibly modest.
All right, let's turn to David Kelly and get your reaction, David, both to what Tom just said and to the overall sort of zeitgeist that is at play here right now. Tom points out that cutting interest rates from where he sits wouldn't improve the matter of trade tangles. What do you think the chairman and his brethren there and sisters there see that some who are more hesitant don't?
Well, they seem obsessed with the inflation idea. I mean, I thought it was really interesting that the chairman said that he wanted to fight for inflation at 2%. Or fight at 2% to keep inflation up to 2% or to get it up to 2%. So they don't want to find themselves in a Japanese situation with inflation running seriously low and they can't push it up. I also thought it was interesting that he said, you know, we want 2%. We don't want 1.7. We don't want 1.8. We want 2. So clearly he's saying, look, this is not about a weakening economy. This is about inflation. That's why we're going to cut. Now, they're saying that. The problem with that, that's a slippery slope because we may not get to 2% inflation. Does that justify October? Does that justify December? You could go all the way down to zero on the federal funds rate and not get to 2% inflation. I tend to agree with Tom that it won't stimulate the economy. But at the moment, the Fed seems determined to acquiesce, I guess, to the political demands, to what the market seems to expect.
So, David,
it seems willing to acquiesce to give us these lower rates.
Just to be clear, you think they're going to cut not because you think they should, but just because you think they will?
Yes, I think so. I think we're fundamentally making a mistake here. I think the Chairman Powell admits that really it is fiscal policy that's got any possibility at all of stimulating the economy. Not by the way that you need to stimulate an economy when you've got a 3.7% unemployment rate, but I think the Fed is. I think that they're worried about independence. I think they're worried about getting too criticized by the administration.
But if they're worried about independence, and David, I take your point, and thank you for clarifying that. Let me just bring Steve in on this as well. If they're worried about independence, then why do a rate cut that everybody seems to be saying, well, the market kind of wants it, and I guess we could take it. But then the president is calling for it. I mean, wouldn't it
Tyler used the term that? Tyler used the term zeitgeist, which I looked up to make sure it's one of those fancy words that we all misuse. You were 100% correct. The defining spirit or mood of a particular period of history as shown by the ideas and beliefs of the time. Okay, let's fit in monetary policy. Listening to this hearing, the Democrats want the Fed to cut. The Republicans want the Fed to cut. The president wants the Fed to cut. The markets want the Fed to cut. If that's not a zeit and a geist altogether, I don't know what to do with it. And poor old Tom Porcelli and David Kelly don't want him to cut. I think that's not enough heft. All due respect to my very intelligent Absolutely. Colleagues on this panel.
But wouldn't you say, Tom, you can weigh in on this as well, but wouldn't you say there's a lot of people on Wall Street who also think the Fed is going to cut as opposed to just thinking, oh, they definitely should, and that's definitely the right thing to do? And doesn't the justification matter? I mean, the idea that they're going to cut by saying, because it's a slowdown and there's global growth concerns, and okay, well, what about the U.S. economy? And if it's not slowing, why can't they just say, yeah, we're going to cut, the economy's strong, but productivity, I mean, the messaging is completely muddled as far as I can tell.
I could not agree more with that, Kelly. And I would say, you know, this might come as a surprise to some of your viewers, but we speak with a lot of very significant investors at some of the biggest organizations, as I'm sure David does too. And I can tell you, I was in meetings yesterday. I've been in more meetings this year than I've been in any other year in my career. And in recent meetings, no one is clamoring for the Fed to cut rates. I mean, I want to be really clear on that point. And again, these are some highly sophisticated investors. And no one seems to think that this economy needs a cut. Yet here we are with the Fed about to cut rates.